So let's take our conversation about the validity of field values a little further and look at auditing a cross-field constraint. So remember, this is a constraint where we have multiple fields per item that must be in agreement in some way. Once again, let's look at a Wikipedia page for city, in this case Bern, in the country of Switzerland. So here we have a nice example of a city that has values for population, area, and one for population density. Anytime you have a situation like this, where you can essentially check at least one field against another, you have a nice way of validating field values throughout your entire dataset. So the cross-field constraint here is that population divided by area gives us the population density. And we'll employ this as one check in auditing our data for the city's collection. So here I've written a little program to do exactly that. And it does something like calculate the population density based on the individual values for population and area, and compare that to the population density specified within the dataset itself. And we're just going to make sure the difference isn't more than 10 to account for rounding errors and that sort of thing. Now, this is just a first pass at this, and just an example to show you the type of thing we might do in auditing a cross-field constraint. All right, let's run this. We should only see output here, yep, and we've got a number of bad population densities, or possibly bad population densities. So what I usually do in situations like this is, I pick one, and I basically just go look at the data and see if I can figure out what's going on. Okay, this one stood out to me, so let's go take a look at that. Now, in the interest of time, I've already pulled this one up in our original data set, and I've actually hidden some of the fields here, so it's easier to see the values that we actually care about in this case. So here's the area field population density, and the population total. Now, what we want is for this value divided by this value to be pretty close to this value. And if you look at this, you can see that there's no way that can possibly happen, given the size of this. Okay, and as I look at the rest of these values here, I also see some values that appear to me to be impossibly large as the area of land for a given city, especially given that when I look at the Wikipedia page, and as I look at Wikipedia pages for other cities, I notice that area is actually measured in square kilometers. So there's no way I have this many square kilometers. However, if I look at Yoakum, Texas, I can see that its value for area is 12 square kilometers. My guess is that this is a rounded value. If I go back and look at this data, and if I interpret this instead of kilometers as not even meters but millimeters, then this makes sense. Now, from my perspective, having the land area specified in millimeters is a little crazy, but I can see reasons why the DBpedia folks might have set things up that way. But if I think about shifting the decimal point for this value appropriately so that it describes square kilometers instead of square millimeters, then I end up with a value that's 11.7 square kilometers, which is pretty close to this value right here. And these values were collected some time ago, so I'm willing to bet that our problem here that we're seeing in auditing this cross-field constraint is really one of having made a faulty assumption about the land area. And that, in fact, is what the problem is. And now, of course, in order to verify this, we'd want to look through a number of other fields here and actually maybe do a bit of Googling around to really be sure that that is exactly what's going on here and that it's just an issue of units as opposed to an actual problem with the cross-field constraint that we know has to exist between these three fields. And that's an example of auditing a cross-field constraint in our cities dataset.